Dear viewers, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. May Allah's peace, mercy, blessings be on you. Alhamdulillah, we are continuing within the same chapter of At-Teen, the chapter of Fig, where Allah Almighty is saying the chapter Fig, verse number 5. And we stopped at the verse ثُمَّ رَدَّدْنَاهُ أَسْفَلَ سَافِلِينَ And we returned him to the lowest of the low. And I mentioned in the last episode that it has two meanings. What it means, lowest to the low or of the low. Allah Almighty, when He created the insan, the man, the human being, He said, لَقَدْ خَلَقْنَا الْإِنسَانَ فِي أَحْسَنِ تَقْوِيمٍ And we give an example that Allah Almighty created the man, the human being, in a best form. And after that, immediately in the verse number 5, Allah Almighty said, ثُمَّ رَدَدْنَاهُ أَسْفَلَ سَافِلِينَ And then we returned him into the lowest of the low. The first meaning of this verse is after Allah Almighty created this man in a best form, in a best shape, and he was young and he was good, with the time, with the stage, Allah Almighty made him weak, made him low, made him old, that now he is not able to do anything. Barely he can walk, or sometime the person cannot walk. He needs someone to assist him. He needs someone to help him. He needs a wheelchair. He needs a stick. He needs anything that, you know, can help him. So this is one of the meaning that after Allah Almighty created this man in a good form, in a best shape, Allah Almighty will put him back into the lowest condition, that he is not able to even eat sometime. He is not able to go to the bathroom by himself. He needs someone with him. So this is life. Sometime you're good, sometime you're bad. Sometime you're healthy, sometime you're sick. Sometime you're young, sometime you're old. So that's obviously is happening to all of us. But again, if your relation is good with Allah Almighty, you are always satisfied. And Allah Almighty will keep you to live in this world with satisfaction. And then after that, Allah Almighty said, إِلَّا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ فَلَهُمْ أَجْرٌ غَيْرُ مَمْنُونَ This is what exactly I was telling you before coming to this ayah, before coming to this verse. Allah says, إِلَّا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا Except those who have iman, who have faith in Allah. وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ And they do righteousness, they do good deeds. فَلَهُمْ أَجْرٌ غَيْرُ مَمْنُونَ For them, there is reward, uncountable reward, endless reward. So, Allah Almighty created you in a best form, and all of us in a best form. And some of the people, and then Allah says, ثُمَّ رَدَدْنَاهُ The same man, the same human being that Allah Almighty created, going down all the way to the lowest, to the worst condition. And I didn't say the second meaning of the same ayah, ثُمَّ رَدَدْنَاهُ أَسْفَلَ سَافِلِينَ The first one, as the scholar said, that he will make this man to go to the lowest condition, to become old, to become unable to do things by himself. And the other meaning of the ulama that they said, that Allah will put him أَسْفَلَ سَافِلِينَ beneath and below the hell. If he is disobedient to Allah Almighty, if he is not listening to Allah Almighty, if he is not obeying and following the instructions of Allah Almighty, not only that, he is denying and not following Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. So, we have to follow the path of Allah and the path of Rasulullah, peace be upon him. And we will take a short break and continue after that, so stay with us. Dear viewers, welcome back. So as I said, two meanings of one verse, that is ثُمَّ رَدَدْنَاهُ أَسْفَلَ سَافِلِينَ, and Allah returned him to the lowest of the low, which is number one, that Allah Almighty will make a man or a human being into the lowest condition after he was created in the best shape. He become weak, he become old, he is not able to walk, he is not able to sit on the floor because his knees hurting, etc., etc. And the other meaning of the scholars, they said, ثُمَّ رَدَدَاهُ أَسْفَلَ سَافِلِينَ, that Allah Almighty will put him down, deep down in the hell, if he is disobedient to Allah Almighty, if he is not listening to Allah Almighty, and he is not following and implementing the instructions of Allah and the Prophet of Allah. Except some people. And this is where Allah Almighty says, إِلَّا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ, except those who have iman, those who have faith, believe in Allah Almighty, وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ, and they do righteousness, they do good deeds. What about them? فَلَهُمْ أَجْرٌ غَيْرُ مَمْنُونَ, for them there is a reward countless, endless, something that they will be pleased with, this kind of reward that Allah Almighty is giving them. And then Allah Almighty said after that, فَمَا يُكَذِّبُكَ بَعْدُ بِالدِّينِ, and what yet cause you to deny the day of judgment? What is making you to deny the day of judgment? Allah is giving you a simple example that Allah created you in the best form. You was in the best form and then you become weak. So this is the condition of this world, and then you will die, right? And you will be rewarded on the day of judgment. And everyone, almost everyone, is going deep down to the hell, except إِلَّا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ, except those who have faith in Allah Almighty, except those who does righteousness, except those who do good things. فَلَهُمْ أَجْرٌ غَيْرُ مَمْنُونَ, for them there is a reward that they will feel good about it. They will be happy to getting this reward, unless reward they will get. So Allah is asking now everyone, the Muslims and non-Muslims and the atheists and all these different people, فَمَا يُكَذِّبُكَ بَعْدُ بِالدِّينِ, what makes you to deny, what cause you to deny the day of judgment, يَوْمُ الدِّينِ, what cause you to deny, فَمَا يُكَذِّبُكَ بَعْدُ بِالدِّينِ, and what also makes you to deny the religion. الدين could be the religion, and بالدين it could be the day of judgment. مالك يوم الدين, Allah Almighty, he said about himself that he is the owner of the day of judgment. So what makes you to deny him? Everything shows that Allah is one, Allah is there, Allah will give you the reward, Allah will take you into the high level if you believe in him and you follow his instructions. And if you do the opposite, there is also the consequences of it. فَمَا يُكَذِّبُكَ بَعْدُ بِالدِّينِ, what's making you to deny and lie the day of judgment? Think about it. And then Allah Almighty said, أَلَيْسَ اللَّهُ بِأَحْكَمِ الْحَاكِمِينَ, Allah says, أَلَيْسَ اللَّهُ بِأَحْكَمِ الْحَاكِمِينَ, isn't Allah Almighty, he is the most just of the judges? أَحْكَمِ الْحَاكِمِينَ, he is the most judge amongst any of the judges. So why we are denying Allah Almighty? Even though we know that Allah Almighty, he is the most merciful, he started every single chapter of in his book with Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, the most merciful, the most compassion. If we look into his names and attributes in the Quran, you will find Al-Wadud, the most kind, Ar-Rahim, the merciful, and you will find a lot of other names, Ar-Rahman and Al-Wadud, and all these other names and the attributes of Allah Almighty that shows us that how merciful he is. Al-Ghaffar, the most forgiven, Al-Ghafoor, the immense Allah Almighty who's forgiving. But yet we are denying Yawm al-Din. We are denying the فَمَا يُكَذِّبُكَ بَعْدُ بِالدِّينِ, that what makes you deny the day of judgment? Don't you think, أَلَيْسَ اللَّهُ بِأَحْكَمِ الْحَاكِمِينَ, don't you think that Allah Almighty, isn't Allah Almighty, he is the most just of judges? Indeed he is. By that, alhamdulillah, we are done with the chapter of At-Teen, the chapter of the fig. And insha'Allah ta'ala, we will continue in the next episode with the new chapter. So stay with us until the next halaqah. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.